Good day to each and everyone who is attending virtually present at this time of our graduation ceremonies for our beloved and very precious graduates for the school year, which ends at this time. First of all, I'd like to greet the parents and family members without whose sacrifices, whose reminders, and whose participation in the learning process for our graduates have resulted in this culmination program. This year, your role has changed drastically. Where we've always thought, we've always believed that the matter of educating our children rests nearly exclusively on our teachers and our staff. This time, you parents, you family members, you who are in the households of our learners, have expanded your role and contributed to this wonderful day wherein finally, finally, our learners are graduating in this culmination exercise. So, congratulations, because this year has not been very easy, has not been a picnic for our teachers, for our family members, as well, especially the parents, mothers, fathers, sisters, brothers, and all who have contributed to the achievement of our learners at this time. So, maraming salamat at congratulations, parents and family members. Mas malaki ang role ninyo at this time compared to earlier graduation exercises. Secondly, I would also like to greet our teachers without whose very careful review and careful supervision of the work of our pupils and our learners, this event would not be taking place at all. And so thank you, teachers. Your role has also expanded. In addition to seeing to it that the modules are faithfully followed, the assignments are correctly implemented, and the learners are truly learning. And you have had to deal with new ways of assessing the performance also of the learners. So, congratulations, teachers, for enduring, for your patience, for your love for our learners, and your willingness to engage in a way and methods of teaching which are different from those which are used to. Assessment must have been especially difficult for you, especially since you were not able to see most of the time our students in face-to-face meetings, and most of the meetings, of course, were virtual. We'd also like to thank the local government units for their interest, for their cooperation, and for their continuing contributions to the needs of education, even as our children do not go to school. Your donations of material as well as financial resources at this time are most welcome, and your advice has been taken seriously, not only by our teachers, by our school officials, but also by our officials in the Department of Education. We continually talk with local government units, especially in times of disaster, in times of great need for classrooms, for space, and for responses to unforeseen emergencies. Thank you, local government units. But of course, most of the congratulatory greetings fall on the deserving graduate. Each and every one of you is truly special. You are different from the other graduates who have passed through the portals of your school. You went to school practically without seeing your teachers, if at all. You went to school with your parents, your mothers, and your fathers hovering over your shoulders and seeing to it that you are able to complete your assignments. You are completing your studies at a time when examinations and assessments are different. You are culminating this long months of hard work at this time, even as you have to do family chores, even as you are distracted, and even as your world has turned upside down, and it seems and it appears as if we don't know what the future holds and what will happen next. But you have persevered, and now you are ready to graduate. And therefore, you deserve each and every bit of congratulations from us in the Department of Education, from your parents and family members, your teachers, from the officials in local government, as well as in the parent teachers associations. You deserve each and every single congratulatory pat on your back, each hug virtually, of course, and each greeting, which I am sure you are also receiving virtually. I don't know if you will remember this event many, many years from now. I have tried to recall myself who our graduation speaker was when I finished high school and when I finished my college studies. All I remember is that the graduation speaker was someone important, someone who was invited because that someone is supposed to give a message. What was more important to us graduates at that time was the excitement of the celebrations, the happiness and the joy of our parents, the sadness of parting from our classmates and from our teachers, and the enjoyment of all the graduation events that usually take place come commencement day. When I was a college student, we had a series of events which were designed to embed in our minds, which were designed to help us remember and not forget our days in college. We would spend one whole day going around the campus, visiting the classrooms, saying goodbye to our teachers, and sharing memories. We would have bonfires to say goodbye to each other. We had baccalaureate services where we committed ourselves to God and we prayed for guidance when we go out into the world. So many celebrations, and the speaker, of course, is the least important and easily forgotten component of the graduation exercise. Nonetheless, I will exert all efforts to share with you what I see are things or issues which a graduate should remember, and recall. I have said that you are very special. You are very different. You are pioneering. There has been no other class like your class. There has been no other graduate like you as a graduating student, because you are the very first graduate of the blended learning response to education in the Philippines. And so you ask yourself, what awaits you in the world outside? You can either work, because the kind of curriculum you survived and underwent as a student will enable you to go to work if you wish to go to work. Some of you will proceed to further studies, and this would be a wonderful thing because there are many opportunities for further expanding your knowledge, for further answering and looking for explanations of issues, events that make you curious, especially in science, in technology, and also in the arts. So you can work, you can go to further studies, and perhaps some of you will settle down, hopefully not too soon, so you can pursue what you really want to do. So today, this is why we call this exercise a commencement exercise. It's not the end of our studies. It's not the end of all our efforts with blended learning, with modules, with floods, with earthquakes, and of course, with COVID. It's a commencement of doors opening to you. More doors will be opened because you are a graduate. You can work. You can proceed for further studies. You can help your parents. And you can perhaps look for opportunities to do what you have always wanted to do, whether at work, whether at advanced studies, whether at learning more in science and technology, in mathematics, and in the arts. All of these opportunities are available to you. More doors are being opened. I hope you will select the door which arouses your curiosity, the door which will help you know more about this world, and the door which will allow you to contribute to the development of our country and contribute whatever we can to solve our problems and our challenges. Congratulations once more to each and every one of you. Congratulations to you, parents and family members. Congratulations to you, teachers. When I was chair of the board of Silliman University, each time we had graduation ceremonies, during the baccalaureate and during commencement itself, I would cry. I would cry because you are sending out into the world a new batch of graduates. And we want to be sure that what is awaiting them is appropriate. We want to be sure that they are ready for what awaits them when they select which door to open. And so, we tell you, go out to the world, do whatever you want to do. God be with you, and be assured that all of us love each and every one of you. Congratulations.
Our distinguished guests, their parents, PTA and barangay officials, beloved principal, committed teachers, proud parents, graduates, and completers. Today, we all celebrate because another fruitful year has passed despite the pandemic. This only proves that nothing is impossible to achieve with our strong will and commitment in our endeavor. You, completers and graduates, are the living witnesses to these virtues because your will and ardent desire to finish the secondary education have brought you to this momentous event of your completion and graduation. Indeed, this is another milestone of your life. But may I remind you that after today, you must amass more energy to prepare yourself for another journey. Let your sacrifices in the past be your inspiration until you reach the ultimate page of your dream. And soon you will come back to this humble institution, already successful in the millions. Sa araw na ito, gusto ko rin bigyan din ang tagumpay nyo ay tagumpay din ng inyong mga magulang. Higit kanino man, ang kanilang sakripisyo ay naging instrumento upang kayo ay makapagtapos ng sekundarya. Kaya't ako'y nagpupugay sa inyong mga magulang sapagkat di sila sumuko at nagtuloy-tuloy ang kanilang pagpapunyagi. Ngunit katulad ng hapon ko sa inyong mga anak, mga magulang, umaasa ako na pagkatapos ng araw na ito, kayo ay mas lalo pang lalakas hanggang sa pagkatapos ng kolehiyo ng inyong mga anak. Ang umaayaw ay di nagwawagi at ang nagwawagi ay di umaayaw, ika nga. I wish also to congratulate the teachers for having adjusted to the new modalities of teaching. They have exemplified flexibility in times of crisis, and as a result, they succeeded to continue educating the learners despite the pandemic. My dear teachers, keep up the good work. Stop not to become instruments of change among our children until they reach their ultimate goal. Again, my congratulations to all of you, dear teachers, in whose hands lies the future of our youngsters. Mabuhay ang pinagpipitagang para lang ito.
It is with great pleasure to greet the completers and the graduates of the school year 2020-2021, both the elementary and the secondary levels of our town Puso Rubio, for successfully finishing school in spite of the challenges, the obstacles brought about by the COVID-19 pandemic. Strengthening the quality of education amid the COVID-19 pandemic, the theme of this year's commencement exercise suggests commitment, focus, and discipline you have shown in your journey for today's celebration. I am also grateful for the dedication manifested by the teachers and the school administrators as you continually supported and eagerly inspired the parents and the learners to finish school against the odds around us. This is your shining moment in exemplifying your para sa bata, para sa bayan mandate. Hence, my congratulations to everyone for keeping up with your responsibilities and duties to your schools and beloved town. Mabuhay and God bless us all.
School head, Dr. Roberto B. Quezon, administrative staff, faculty, fellow junior high school completers, and friends, a pleasant day to all. Today is indeed a remarkable one. I am greatly honored to speak for this momentous event. First and foremost, glory to God. If not for His divine mercy, we may not be here today witnessing this virtual occasion. I thank the Lord Jesus Christ for sparing every one of us from the deadly COVID-19. Who would have thought? It's been more than a year since we last convened in the four corners of our classrooms, intently listening and interacting with each other during our lectures. It was March of the year 2020 when we were robbed off of our chance to create more memories together, to enjoy our remaining time in our beloved school, Benigna B. Aldana National High School. Academic year 2020-2021 was, without a doubt, a challenging year for all of us. The changes caught us by surprise and knocked us off our feet. We took our time adjusting to the restrictions of the new normal and the adversities of the new learning delivery modality. Shifting our paradigm from listening to our teachers' discussions to managing and self-directing our learning bewildered us for a while. Self-learning is an arduous task and is not as easy as learning the ABC. It requires patience, perseverance, and broad knowledge, which not everyone possesses. We have undergone a lot of stress, fought silent battles among ourselves, combated our frustrations, and encouraged ourselves to keep going. But still, we would like to extend our appreciation to our school head and teachers for their best efforts in providing us the much-needed support. They have risked their lives going to school, printing our modules and activity sheets so that we could continue our education. It was also hard for them, but they chose to do it, being committed to their profession. For that, please accept our heartfelt gratitude to all of you. I would also like to thank our family, fellow completers, and friends for the support system and sharing the burden with us. Padayon Batch 2021. Padayon, future doctors, teachers, lawyers, accountants, nurses, and many others. Move forward, continue despite the hardships. Keep going with life. It's been a tough year, but I want you to remember just one thing. We made it. Be proud of it. We have faced challenges and emerged victoriously. We may have been suffocated and overwhelmed, but we have successfully swum back to the surface and survived. We have never let the waves drown us. Let's pull ourselves together and make headway. Just as Henry Ford once said, whether you think you can or whether you think you can't, you are right. So keep believing and soar high. Padayon and congratulations, Junior High School Completers Batch 2020-2021. Good luck with your next journey. Godspeed and thank you very much.
Congratulations, fellow completers, for this school year 2020-2021. Today is indeed a great day, a day we've all been waiting for since we entered 7th grade. We finally made it amidst the challenges of pandemic. we will accomplish one of the early major milestones of our lives. And this success is the product of all the life formulas taught us by different valuable players in our lives. First, we offer the highest praises and glory to God behind this triumph for giving us the light, good health, and wisdom to beat the challenges brought to us by this world pandemic. Second, we thank our very supportive, proud parents and guardians. They're the people who never left our sides. Instead, filled us with love, care, and guidance, and for letting us walk on the straight path in the right way. They are the ones who worked and kept on working very hard for us to achieve our desires in life. We all know how glad and pleased they are with our fulfillments in life. Our success is their success too. Next is our beloved Principal Dr. Roberto B. Quezon, Mathematics Department Head Dr. Ana Perla B. D. Guzman, all other heads of the different departments and teachers. Thank you very much for helping us accomplish this achievement. You have been our mothers, fathers, and friends during our stay in our beloved alma mater. More so, we witness how you doubled your effort, time, and resources as our second parents so that we still get the quality of learning, even in these difficult circumstances where modules became part of our daily lives. Thank you for building, enhancing, and preparing us to become responsible individuals and core members of our society as the next generation who will serve and protect our country, carrying the excellent quality of education you have provided us. And most importantly, let's all thank ourselves for working hard for the past few years, for not giving up the fight until we reach this point to pursue our dreams. It always seems impossible until it's done. I assume that we all agree that at some point of our lives being a student, there was a time that we were very discouraged and tired and thought of giving up, stop on the place where we were and discontinued treading the path because everything appeared to be impossible. But look at us now, because we believe of ourselves that we can do it, and with the support of our loved ones, parents, teachers, and friends, we became stronger, bolder, and motivated, and expanded our horizons in understanding the challenges that molds us to become the finest diamonds to behold. Once again, thank you and congratulations to all of us, my fellow Batch 2021 completers. God bless us all.
To our Municipal Mayor, Honorable Emma Zusimal Ichan, to our Education Program Supervisor 1, in charge for TLE, Dr. Virgilio R. Barba, to our School Principal 4, the very handsome and hardworking Dr. Roberto B. Quezon, to our handsome and energetic Assistant Principal 2, Mr. Ras D.V. Basbas, to the members of faculty, parents, viewers, the amazing class of 2021, my fellow completers, ladies and gentlemen, good day. It has been 4 years of new beginnings, new adventures, new memories, and new friendships that will last a lifetime. Never have I imagined that my final year as a junior high school student will be an extraordinary one. We have seen our fair share of hardships, especially our senior year of learning a whole new normal due to COVID-19. Our 10th grade in Binigno V. Aldana National High School may not have been what we expected, but we adapted to the restrictions and overcame the challenges of being a junior high school student during a pandemic. As lockdown was announced, face-to-face learning was canceled. A gloomy afterthought resides in my mind that we were forced to forego wonderful experiences that often accompanied the final year of high school. But the Department of Education offers the modular distance learning to continue education, despite the challenges brought forth by the pandemic. Learning remotely developed our discipline and deep sense of responsibility. The commitment to finish tasks assigned and perform performance tasks is beyond unimaginably. We have now learned how to foster relationships through these tough times. Quite literally, finding the meaning behind the saying, through thick and thin, we were thrown into this thunderstorm of uncertainty
and irregularities throughout the year. But we fought through it, through ways we could have never imagined. This is the moment where we contemplate and celebrate our vanquishes and victories. It is quite an honor to be standing among this class. I am happy that we reached this milestone together, and all the moments we have shared are gems in the galaxy of our memories. As friends, competitors, and contemporaries, I would like to inspire every completer of my batch. We should never abandon the good seeds sown in our heart by our dear alma mater. We should always remember that we are representatives of Binigno V. Aldana National High School, its values, traditions, and honor. Fly high, my fellow completers! Make our alma mater proud. This moment also presents a chance for me to sincerely give thanks to people who made our junior high school years happy and memorable. I would like to extend my deepest gratitude to our teachers for constantly guiding us and supporting us in our academic journey. Thank you for providing us challenges and obstacles that ignites our inquisitive side to prosper and improve. To my advisor, Ma'am Susan Cabanilla, thank you for your kind help in mastering valuable skills and knowledge. You have played a vital role in molding our personality and constantly encourage us. To my friends, thank you for being that alter ego that constantly challenges, motivates, and comforts me. Our time together will be treasured forever in my heart. To my parents, Papa Luis and Mama Marilo, whom I indebted my life, thank you for being the ultimate model of love and sacrifice. You have showed me that no matter how hard life is, I can always find comfort, assurance, and protection within your canopy of love. To my siblings, Jonaline, Joanne, Luis, and Julian, you have provided me the foundation of competitiveness. Without you, my life will be dull and colorless. Your presence served as extension of our parents' love and care. You provided another fuel for me to use to succeed in life. I love you both. To God Almighty, whom I indebted everything that I have, thank you, Father, for all the blessings that you have given me. I will always humble myself before you. We have all faced a challenging high school experience that has never happened before, and we overcame it, made it worthwhile. Together, we can be the light of the world. Completers of Batch 2020-2021, enjoy today. Bask in the glory of success, because each of us has earned it. Thank you.
Mga kababayan, ang pambansang awit ng Pilipinas.
Kayang mag-iliw, Diyos ng sinahanan, alam ng puso, sa titik mo'y buhay. Upang hinirang, kuyat ka ng magiting, sa mandulupin, di ka pasisigil. Sana natatutok sa simoy at sa nanikaw pagraw, ay hinanap tulakawin sa pagkaya minamahal. Ang isang kapatawa at mo'y tatong ay nanaginimig, ang pituwing at araw niya kailan ang may di matitinig. Luma na araw ng buwan, hating pansin ka, buhay langit sa pinig mo.
When I am down, And oh, my soul so weary, when troubles come and my heart burden be, then I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can.
Lessons, it prevails, I work and pray. safe and happy as I live on day by day. Go to other lands I wander as I search for wealth and fame. In my heart I will remember Region 1, beloved name. Region 1, oh Region 1, there's no better place I see. Region 1, oh Region 1, dearest of my heart to be. Motherless I wander as I search for wealth and fame. In my heart I will remember Region 1, beloved name.
Region 1!
Bangga sinan tuh. far and wide. Historic hometown, wealthy and cultured, Pozorubio Ilimin. Oh, beloved Pozorubio, we are proud, loyal and true. A melting pot of peace-loving people, Pozorubio Balaymi. O Naranyaka, Pozorubio, with joy and pride we offer thee. We pledge our loyalty undivided, Pozorubian strong and free. We are grateful, God Almighty, we offer all to thee. God bless us all, Pozorubians, in our town and home.